Welcome back to the channel, guys. So today is an exciting day. I am going on a bike ride to Mekedatu. It's around 100 kilometers from Bangalore. After 5 months, I have this chance of taking my bike out for a long ride. So just last minute trip, that was South Indian Odyssey. If you have not seen the series, here is the link. Check it out. I have received a few questions from you guys on my social handles where you want to know whether you should buy an entry level DSLR or not. So I'm not an expert, but from last few years I have been experimenting with my DSLR, so I have a little bit of experience. So in this vlog we will be answering the question whether you should buy an entry level DSLR or not. But we won't do that sitting here. We'll go out and then we will talk about it. So one more thing, Nikki won't be coming with us on this bike ride. It is just me and Hitesh. So I will change quietly and I will leave. अगर मैंने निक्की को गलती से भी जगा दिया ना तो भड़क जाएगी. So let's talk about buying an entry level DSLR for photography first. Right now, if you are just a beginner, you don't know why you want to buy an DSLR for photography, I think entry level will do fine for you. Even in the future, if you go for, you know, into the business of photography, like clicking pre-wedding photographs or shooting a model or kind of stuff where action happens not very fast, where you have all the time in the world to click the photograph, what I would suggest is your entry-level camera will do fine there. Just buy a set of cool lenses. But if you're thinking that in the near future your focus will be photographing the action which happens very fast, like sports photography or wildlife photography, or if you think that your interest lies in clicking cool low light photographs, your entry level DSLR won't do the justice over there. Then only you should go for semi-professional or professional DSLRs, because they can click a lot of photographs in very short amount of time and also not lose the details. They are good with low light conditions. So unless you are going to click most of your photographs in low light, or you know, click an action which is very fast, you are good with an entry level DSLR with a set of cool lenses. One more thing which is very important with photograph is your editing. You need to learn how to edit, and you know, you need to know about the colors. Your editing will make a lot of difference in your photographs. So now we are on Kanakpura Road and it will take us another 2 hours to reach to the destination. But before that, we will stop for breakfast. There is one place where we always have breakfast on Kanakpura Road. We will stop there, have breakfast and continue our journey. So a lot of you have been asking me about my bike. Dekh lo abhi. Check out Hitesh's bike. लोएस्ट कर रखने की कोशिश करता
हूँ. हाँ हाँ.
So we have stopped at this place and we are having coffee, and ये जो इडली है ना, इसको क्या बोलते हैं हितेश सर?
टट्टे इडली.
इसको टट्टे इडली बोलते हैं. बहुत टेस्टी होती है. तो मैं हितेश, मेरे फ्रेंड है एंड आई ऑलवेज कॉल हिम हितेश सर बिकॉज आउट ऑफ रेस्पेक्ट आई थिंक. हमें कितना टाइम हो गया एक साथ राइड किए. एक्सटेंशन में पहली बार किया था. हाँ, पाँच छः साल हो गया हम एक साथ राइड करते रहते हैं. क्या आपने पिछला ट्रिप कौन सा किया था?
लेह लद्दाख.
हाँ, इन्होंने लेह लद्दाख को भी किया था. उसकी वीडियोस हैं आपके पास है, बट इन्होंने अभी पोस्ट नहीं किए हैं. बट अगर वो जब वो पोस्ट करेंगे मैं एक लिंक डाल दूंगा, यू कैन चेक हिम आउट एज वेल. तो आई थिंक इसके बाद कोई रेस्टोरेंट हमें नहीं मिलेगा खाने को. दैट्स वाई वी हैड ब्रेकफास्ट. नाउ वी विल गो डायरेक्टली टू मेकेदातु.
गोरिल्ला पॉट
लेना है. गोरिल्ला पॉट भी लेना है. 4,500 का आता है. सो वी हैव रीच द स्पॉट. अभी ये जो छोटी छोटी बोट्स हैं इससे क्रॉस करके उस तरफ जाना है, और उस तरफ जाके बस मिलती है और वो आपको ले जाती है वहाँ पे जहाँ पे शैलो रॉक्स हैं. नहीं क्या, कुछ रॉक्स वॉक्स है उसके बीच में से पूरा ये जो कावेरी रिवर का पानी हो जाता है. So right now we are at Sangam. Is jagah ko Sangam bolte because there are two rivers that meet here. Two or three, I'm not sure. Tu bhi hai kya?
Ye udhar ja rahi hai.
Do hi hai. Ek wahan se aa rahi hai, ek yahan se. Wahan se. Aur ek wahan se river. Ye sab udhar ja rahi hai. Dar lag raha hai kya?
Nahi. Kiya hua hai.
Meri thodi thodi phat rahi hai bhai. एक्चुअली मैंने सुना है इस रिवर में क्रोकोडाइल भी है. नहीं सच्ची मैं हमेशा मजाक करता रहता हूँ बट मैंने सुना है इस रिवर में क्रोकोडाइल है. दैट्स व्हाई मेरी थोड़ी फट रही है. अब हम बस में यहाँ से एक व्यू पॉइंट है. बम्पी राइड है. So the bus drive was like 10-15 minutes and after that we have reached this viewpoint. It's not that beautiful as it looks on the Google reviews. But let's see, what we are going to do is fly a drone. Yeah, drone udana bhi allowed nahi hai yahan pe. Drone allowed hi nahi. The drone shots sir ka jo ड्रोन है मैविक. कौन सा है? मैविक एयर. मैविक एयर है. वी कुडंट रिकॉर्ड एनीथिंग. बहुत अच्छा व्यू आता बट दे डिडंट अलाउ. अगर आप यहाँ आ रहे हो और आप चाहते हो ड्रोन शॉट से ना किसी तरीके से जो कंडक्टर है ना बस का उससे बचो एंड देन गो समवेयर एंड देन देख ड्रोन शॉट्स. सो इफ यू आर कमिंग टू Mekedatu. Mekedatu नाम है कि Mekedatu. तो हमने अभी जो ये क्या बोलते हैं जो गोल वाली इसको क्रॉकल ऐसा कुछ बोलते हैं ना
वाली ना
गोल नाउ लेट्स कॉल इट गोल बोट जो उसका पायलट है. पायलट ही बोलते हैं क्या बोलेंगे इसको. चलो पायलट. हाँ नाविक. जो नाविक है उसने बताया कि देर आर क्रोकोडाइल्स है बट दे डोंट अटैक द यू नो लिविंग बींग्स. दे ईट रॉटन फ्लैश. बट मैं इतना चांस लेना नहीं चाहूँगा. अगर आप यहाँ आते हो नदी में डीप में मत जाना. देर आर क्रोकोडाइल्स एंड क्रोकोडाइल्स से ज़्यादा खतरनाक यहाँ पे वर्पूल्स है. फ्रॉम माई एक्सपीरियंस आई हैव फेस थ्री प्रॉब्लम्स विद एन एंट्री लेवल DSLR लाइक कैनन 700 डीप फॉर वीडियोज़. फर्स्ट थिंग इज इट शूट्स फुल HD एट ओनली 24 एंड एट मैक्स 25 फ्रेम्स पर सेकेंड. जो भी मूवीज़ देखते हैं उसमें 24 फ्रेम पर सेकेंड वाला वीडियो होता है और अगर कोई एक्शन मूवी है इट इज़ अराउंड 30 फ्रेम्स पर सेकेंड. बट मोस्ट ऑफ द वीडियोज़ आर एट 24 और 25 फ्रेम्स पर सेकेंड. मोस्टली जो भी एंट्री लेवल DSLRs है दे विल शूट फुल HD एट 25 फ्रेम्स पर सेकेंड. सो यू डोंट हैव दोज एक्स्ट्रा फ्रेम्स एंड स्लो मोशन. अगर आप सॉफ्टवेयर से करोगे द सॉफ्टवेयर विल क्रिएट सैम्पल्स बाई इट्सल्फ. दैट इज़ नॉट एक्चुअल फ्रेम राइट. If you have, you know, some camera, let's say entry level से थोड़ा सा ऊपर आप चले जाओ you have M50 which shoots full HD at 60 frames per second. So आपके 60 frames per second. तो अगर आप उसको slow करना चाहते हो आप more than 50% उसको slow कर सकते हो. तो you have those extra frames and you can show them in 2 seconds. Same जो आपने 1 second में खींचे वो 2 second में दिखाओ. तो you have those extra frames and slow motion looks very smooth. If you don't know, I have from last 2 or 3 vlogs I have changed my you know settings from full HD जो कि 25 frames per second था to 720 at 50 frames per second. और वीडियो का क्वालिटी बहुत अच्छा हो गया. स्लो मोशन इतना स्मूथ लगता है. सॉफ्टवेयर cannot do that. So don't rely on the software. So this is the first problem if you are going to buy a entry level DSLR for creating videos.
सो सो
सो सो ना. So we are sitting here at Sangam and we are having fish. Also, I will tell you the second reason why entry level camera is not good for video shooting, for vlogging. And the second reason is autofocus. So right now autofocus is on. Abhi face track kiya Hitesh ka. Abhi face track kar raha aapka. Ab aap bottle la do. Ab main chahta hu ki bottle mein focus kare. Abhi tak nahi aaya, ab aaya, ab focus kiya bottle pe. So it takes lot of time to focus on things. So I'm still shooting it in autofocus. So sometimes it will track your face. Abhi jaise track kar raha, it is tracking fine, but when you change the subject, it takes a lot of time to change the focus from one subject to another subject. And also it makes a lot of noise while it is, trying to regain the focus. So jo entry level DSLRs hote hain, unme jo autofocus system hota, that is not that great. For vlogging, you need to, show something like this. Ye meri bike hai, dekho. Yeah, you need to show some other friend. But if that is not in focus, it does not look good. What I have to do is, I always turn it to manual and then I change the focus manually. So we just had fantastic kind of snack, fish. Then we are leaving. We will go back to Bangalore and I will tell you more about the camera stuff at home. Kya hua? Sab theek?
Huh?
Phone aa raha hai kya? So finally we have got network. I will call Netika. So Nikki was not able to come on this trip. She was not feeling well in the morning.
Hello.
हाँ जी कैसे हो?
बस ठीक.
चलो मैं अभी निकलता हूँ ठीक है?
हाँ ठीक है ठीक है. कैसी लगी जगह?
अच्छी है, मस्त है.
फोटोज वीडियो
उतनी खास नहीं है वैसे. To go and we will be home.
Okay, so the third issue that I want to talk about is the performance of an entry-level DSLR in low light. Right now I am shooting on an entry-level DSLR, Canon 700D. You can see a lot of noise here. So if I had a camera which performs better in low light along with my entry-level DSLR, what you would see right now is very less noise in a semi-professional or professional camera, and that too at the same ISO settings. Okay, to summarize all the issues that I found out with an entry-level DSLR for creating videos: number one, low frame per second; number two, slow autofocus; and number three is the performance of an entry-level DSLR in low light is not that great. So I have seen people saying ki first you buy an entry-level DSLR, then you go to a semi-professional or a professional one. But what I think is that the gap of learning between an entry-level DSLR and a semi-professional DSLR is not that steep. If you can learn on an entry-level DSLR, you can learn on a semi-professional DSLR. I don't think that reason is, justified enough. Okay, if you are looking for creating videos, what cameras you should buy, I am following a lot of people who create videos on YouTube. So if you are going to vlog, I think Canon M50 and Canon 80D, they are really good cameras for shooting vlogs. Canon's autofocus and color science is the best in the industry right now. And if you are into creating cinematic videos, I think you can go for Sony A63, A65, or if you have some extra cash, I think you can go for A7 as well. Sony cameras, they shoot full HD at 120 frames per second and it looks magical, so smooth. And Sony's performance in low light is also very good. So you may be thinking ki humko itna gyan de raha, but why you are not upgrading? So I think my priority lies somewhere else right now, but in the future if I get some extra cash and a good enough reason, I will change my DSLR. So if you don't have a camera right now and you are thinking of buying a camera for creating videos, don't go for an entry level camera or a camera that does not have any of these features. Go for a camera which has good autofocus, has at least 50 frames per second shooting capability at full HD, and also performs good in low light. But if you already have a camera, make the most out of it, and if you think now is the time to upgrade, you can upgrade. Remember this thing, that the content that you are showing on your videos, that is more important. In the future you can get better quality cameras. Right now if you don't have a better camera, it's fine. Focus on your content right now. With that said, thanks for watching this vlog. I hope this helped you. And if you're planning to go to Mekedatu, it's fine for a small bike ride or a road trip. Don't expect much out of it. that's it. Thanks for watching this vlog. Namaste. Dambaho.